Marriage is very seriously. We
Very
may take it as a
seriously, you know,
joke, but the Lord takes it very seriously, and He wants to establish something powerful through this entire institute of marriage. It's not just a man and woman coming
Absolutely.
together. So it's worth the wait, and it's worth the
It's worth
prayers, and
the
it's
wait.
even worth the tears. So it's
It's worth the
just
tears, yeah.
absolutely. And also, one more thing I wanted to highlight in this was, sometime back I was praying about a woman who was struggling to get married. She had already crossed her 40s, and she was so desperate to get married. And I was not really praying. I just asked God, God, why is this delay happening? Like, why is this happening? And I don't know, but why, it just came into my heart that, you know, she's not ready. So, you know, we focus so much on how are we being ready on the outside, but not ready on the inside. Because it's
Absolutely,
something
yeah.
that God has called us, and it's something really beautiful. God wants to, in a way, entrust a man to us, that this is, you know, a man, and I'm giving you, and I'm asking you know, to partake with him in what I have for him, and
Yes,
for
and
you
you need
both
to be
together
ready
as
for
a
that.
family.
Yeah,
Absolutely.
and
So even in the
even
waiting, just
even
as you said, we have to be ready.
we have to be ready. Yes, you know, one of the things that I learned during this waiting time was, and I just feel when God asked me that question, He sounded a bit strict. You know, this verse in Proverbs 31, and I don't remember the number of the like this. I don't remember the one. Husband all the days of her life, all the days. Can you hear me?
Yes. There's a
Yeah.
lot of
Yeah.
Yeah, now
So
I
a
can.
godly, okay. A godly woman brings good to her husband all the days of her life. And remember, God asking me like a strict father, like He's standing on my head and asking me, is today in all the days? I said, yes. Are you married? I said, no. Do you know your husband? I said, no. But today is in all the days. That means even when you don't know your husband, you are called to bring good to him.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, and I learned that how my every choice, you know, even looking at some man who probably is singing very well in worship, to church worship is, you know, oh, he's so handsome, let me go and just talk to him. Like, no, actually, you know what? I want to bring good to my husband. You know, I'm not going to talk to him. I don't care whether he's the one or not.
And I believe, like, some wives out there, I don't know, some wives may be thinking, like, the Bible really does say that we have to bring good to our husbands, but sometimes it's so hard,
It
you
is
know,
hard,
when
it's
we
not
have
easy.
challenges
I
in our
know.
marriages. We just feel, oh gosh, Lord, I cannot stand this man. That is also a
It
truth, a big truth of marriage,
is,
you know.
it
It's
definitely is.
so even in those times, just to keep our hearts guarded, even though on the outside we may appear to be, oh my goodness, I don't care, but deep within our heart, God gives us that love for that one man. You know,
Yeah,
no matter
yeah.
what we go through, we want to love on him, we want to stand with him, no matter how he
Yeah.
treats us, even. Sometimes, you know, that's also against this entire society's idea of feminism. I'm not saying that we let them walk over us or something, but love is sacrificial in a way. So we have to be prepared for all of that
Absolutely.
in marriage. We are not going to have our own way when we
We are
get
not going to
married
have our
and
own
live our
way.
lives. We have to be
And
prepared to take the
yeah, and
back
see,
seat.
to take the back seat, yes, it's, you know, I was a hustler before I got married. Any problem, let's say at the airport, at the railway station, anywhere, I used to be like, okay, let me figure it out. But you know, after I got married to Ranjit, I always had to take a step back and be like, I know what the solution is. He's going to take like 30 minutes to find the solution, but I want to let him lead.
Yeah.
You know?
So let's just
So
pray for more
yeah.
grace for the wives
It's
to be more
really,
submissive. Oh my goodness, it's so hard at
yes.
times.
Yes,
But
it's so hard. I know. Well, now I find it very funny, you know, when I just want to speak, it's just funny and hard, yeah. And I don't think anything will make you like Christ, like marriage does.
absolutely. Absolutely. I don't know. Even I'm like kind of going off the topics because I'm loving the conversation so much. So
I
and this also happens that no matter the whole world is, you know, falling apart or whatever, but when you're so in tune with your husband or with your spouse, you know, everything seems to be in place in a way, you know, because you have that bonding. But no matter how well everything has been put together, but if things are not well with your spouse, it really affects
Nothing
your
feels good.
heart. Nothing
Yeah,
feels
no,
good.
nothing feels
So it's
good.
just beautiful how God connects us, makes us one. And it's just amazing. So whoever out there is praying to get married, these are all the things that are going to happen and much more than this. So be prepared.
Be
So
prepared.
yes, even while you pray, and please be ready for all of this to happen. And all the women out there, the wives, I just want to tell all of you're doing a good job,
Doing
even
a
if
good
the
job,
enemy tells you that you're not doing good, and sometimes things may not go the way you want, but God is with us in this, and He will make sure that we come out of it powerfully. Yes, so the last thing that I wanted to talk about, so this question I did not send you before, and it's a little bit personal, but I believe you would love to talk about it as far as I've come to know you. So I wanted to know you because I wanted to know from you, you've always been talking about the Father. You know, we serve a triune God, the Father, the Son, and the Spirit. So you've particularly spoken a lot about the Father, you know, and me also personally, I've felt the Father being everything to me, the one who has embraced me in my brokenness because I've had a very bad childhood. So how has this Father, for and this is for the ones who are watching us who do not know the love of God, how has this Father changed your life? And how is this Father different from any other father in the world today? Because some people find their security in their dads. They feel that our earthly father is fine. Why do we need another father? So, what would you say to such people about this great father that we have? How is he different?
How this father has changed my life, I think it's too vast of a topic. And it might sound poetic, but he's given me wings. And he gave me, and you know how. I think our father, that's God, is somebody who has the ability to take care of all our needs. And his ability of taking care of our needs, even those needs that we do not know that we have.
Yeah, absolutely.
And what makes him different from other fathers is that other fathers are human beings, you know, and at one, and you know, and e your father, you know, one of the things that I want to mention and might clarify is that what helped me forgive my father for whatever reasons I had to forgive him was that at one point of time I realized that I might have found, even if I had the best earthly father this world has ever seen, he still could not have been as good as my heavenly father.
Absolutely.
You know? And the day I realized that, I was like, I'm actually not at loss. So if you think you don't, if for the people who think that it's great that you have great fathers, and I'm pretty sure that if you have amazing fathers, it would have been easier for you to relate with our heavenly father. But I think I am more in a place of speaking to people who do not have great fathers, because you know, for me it was a different journey. You know, our heavenly father is nowhere like our earthly fathers, and it's not something that we are called to hold against our earthly fathers. You know, it's not a comparison.
Absolutely.
We need to understand that hey, you didn't love me, but God loved me. You know, we know that. I understand there was a phase in my life where when I was there, when I compared God with my father and be like, you never loved me like God loved me, so you are not even my father. But he's nowhere like human beings. You know, and the way I, as a teenager or as a woman in early 20s, when I found the Lord, I needed his love the same way I think our parents need his love. If there is anybody who could reach out to me, this is very famous about me. This is very famous about me and the gang that I used to hang out with before I got saved. I still talk to them sometimes on and off. That, you know, we don't understand. If there is anybody who could tame you, it was Jesus. Though we don't want to try Jesus, but I don't know how you got tamed. You know, how you actually settled down, because you were so wild. So the love that he has for us, for you and me, I don't think it can be described. It can only be experienced. But if I can describe this, sometimes when I feel like, you know, I don't think God loves me or whatever, blah, 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 or he doesn't love me enough. This is what I remind myself, that even if I go to the deepest of the oceans, his love is even deeper than that. So imagine how much Absolutely. He loves me.
Hmm.
You know? And yes. once you give your life, one of the best things you're going to do is to give your life into his hands. Because he wants to do something great with your life.
Amen. So we just have a few seconds remaining. I just got an alert about the time.
Oh, no.
Yeah, so I hope we could do a part two of it. Let's see. Let's just pray about it and ask God what he thinks. And till then, thank you so much. I love you. Thank you for doing this.
Thank you. Love you.